Hello everyone and welcome to SimQuest TV, 2-Minute Tuesday channel, the original video tech tip series now in its fourth season. My name is Jimmy Brera, I'm a senior application engineer and I work for SimQuest. In this week's episode of What's New in SOLIDWORKS 2015, I'm going to show you a new functionality when using the Move Face tool. Let me show you how it works. First of all, you'll note that the Move Face command now has an improved interface. It now includes additional end condition options in the Property Manager. For example, we can now use the Up to Surface end condition on this face. As soon as you do that, you see that there is an arrow that indicates the direction that the face will move. We select the end face and the command completes successfully. The same applies to other end conditions. For example, offsetting from a face. Just type in the distance, and you're done. Another significant enhancement with the Move Face command is that it now supports multiple body selections. For instance, I have two sheet metal bodies on my screen. With SOLIDWORKS 2015, I can shorten both of them at the same time by using the Move Face command. In addition, you'll notice that now you can type in a numerical value in the callout, which really simplifies things. As you can see, SOLIDWORKS 2015 has taken a very useful command, the Move Face tool, and just made it a whole lot better. Well, that's it for this episode from SimQuest's 2-Minute Tuesdays channel. I hope you enjoyed it, and we'll see you next time.